spooky touch for your home for this Halloween. Specimen jars. These look like they came straight out of a mad scientist laboratory. They're really easy to make, and your trick-or-treaters will love them. Just line these up outside your front door or inside your door where you ask the trick-or-treaters to come in and beg for their treats. Well, it's a new product for me. It's a very interesting product called Encapso. And you use Encapso K, this stuff, one-to-one, and you pour into a container like this and mix them. One's more liquidy than the other. And what you're doing is really making a solid, clear material that will encapsulate whatever you put in it. So it's very, very fun. So that's one-to-one. Stir that for 5 minutes. So I'm not going to stand here for 5 minutes, so we... unfortunately, but we have 1 cup of this liquid already, and we're going to be making a rather unattractive sort of inside of a head, including teeth and eyeballs. So here we just pour that in, let it set, and it has to dry for 2 hours. That's going to dry. So now we have it dry. Look at this. And if you, I need a little thing. If you poke it, it's hard. See, this is not going down. And so we're going to now put our teeth. These are called Billy Bob teeth. Don't ask me why. But they are $5 to $10 at the Halloween store. All the all our sources will be on our website at MarthaStewart.com. And so you're going to now affix the teeth with a little bit of Silpoxy. I would call it Silipoxy, but whatever. So you put a little bit on the edge and a little bit behind. All this dries absolutely clearly. And you put this down like that with a pair of chopsticks. These chopsticks work really well with a rubber band. It makes like a clamp. So that, let that just dry again for 15 minutes. We already have ours dry. See, they're not going to fall out. You can turn it upside down. They're affixed very nicely, encapsulated. And now we pour another 1 1/3 cups. So don't just make one of these. Make several at the same time so you maximize the use of your time, because every one has to dry for 15 or 20 minutes or whatever. And so now this has to stay for about 15 minutes. That will dry. And now we have 2 eyeballs. So see now where it is? Can you see that? It's right above the teeth. And we're going to stick these eyeballs in with some more Silpoxy. And I don't know what we're going to do with all these specimen jars. Any idea, Tom?
Every year
we have Halloween. And every year we come up with more and more elaborate, fabulous, simple ideas. Because this is really simple. You just need a little bit of stuff to do these crazy things. Let that dry for 15 minutes. And now pour your final layer, 1 1/4 cups, right into the eyeballs. And this should dry overnight. When it's totally dry and you're ready for your party, you can put these little puck lights. These cost $5 each. You put that in the bottom of a little sort of tray here. Here's your eyeballs and teeth. That, now see how the light just comes right up through that clear encapsulated stuff. And here we have this dry ice. This is the fun part. Don't touch this. This is not good. This is pure solidified. Is it carbon dioxide? Our dry ice. And then pour a little bit of water while your party is going on. And just keep refreshing the water and you see what happens. You will have a very scary, interesting display. Your cans can be any height. I love all these things. If you'd like more creepy, crafty ideas for Halloween, just go to MarthaStewart.com/Martha.
We'll be right back.